Welcome to Content Conch Pro Gaming, brought to you by Rogue Energy.
Hey guys, what's going on? Some Warzone news for you today. A new trailer showcasing the Fireteam Dirty Bomb mode was released. It's a 40-player, 10-team mini royale type of match that is going to be in the new Cold War game. Not too much known about it just yet, but from the trailer, it does look pretty cool. Some streamers like Nick Merckx were wondering if maybe it did have some relation to what the possible new map for Warzone might be, but we're not too sure. But there were some screenshots shown by Call of Duty News today that show someone jumping out of the air into a heavily wooded area. We're not sure if this is a new Cold War multiplayer feature or what, but it is definitely interesting. I'll just show you a quick clip here of the trailer that was dropped today.
The dirty bombs have come online. Walk in with a captain, cause we know that that don't matter shit. Pointed at him, now he panicking. Got you looking like a mannequin. Game mask, double bag, let's talk, got a cash. Stick to the plan. Stick to the plan. Yeah, stick to the plan. Yeah, contraband, out of bands, just stick to the plan. Hostiles have detonated a dirty bomb. There are now four left.
The video is pretty interesting. We're still not too sure what the integration between Cold War and Warzone is going to look like just yet, but maybe that gives us some indication of maybe how things might look. We're not sure about if there's going to be a new map or if they're going to make big alterations to the map, and we're still not exactly sure how Gunsmith is going to work. JGod does have a video explaining how he's been able to find out some information about how Gunsmith is going to work with the weapon sliders and stuff like that. You can check his video out. It's pretty interesting. We're hoping that they can do something about the hacking. Nick Merckx yesterday played with a hacker who kind of explained how he has 2D and 3D radar. You can see how that'd be a massive advantage, and we're really hoping they can crack stuff down on the hacking area, because really, if you watch Nick Merckx's stream yesterday, it's insane the amount of players who are hacking in these high-level lobbies. Looking at the patch notes now, not too much to talk about, but there has been a massive change for PC players, as you're now able to install certain portions of the game. Console players could do this, now PC players can do this to try and save up space on their hard drive, which is definitely a benefit for players who didn't have the storage space to be able to install the full game. Now, looking specifically at Warzone for everybody here, there has been a buff to the Kar 98. They've increased the minimum damage range, so that way when you're shooting somebody in the leg or one of their extremities, it doesn't take four shots. Now it's probably going to be a 2-3 shot, but to find that out, you'd have to take quite a few shots with it in Warzone, so hard to tell exactly what that damage will be now, but it is increased. They've also reduced the minimum damage range on the SPR 208. Really what that means is if you shoot somebody in the extremity, it's not going to do as much damage. The SPR was pretty heavy. They buffed it last week as well. This buff now kind of balances it. It's still a useful weapon, but now shooting somebody in the knee isn't going to do as much damage. They did have some fixes in the game now for some of the minor glitches, which related to like textures and stuff like that. They've said they fixed the bounty contract issue and the tree, whatever you want to call the crazy gun graphic that would come up. They've claimed to have fixed that. Some other streamers like Cloak today said that they have not and that it still has happened, but maybe it's just less prevalent. But that's pretty much the gist of the patch notes. Mostly just collision detection and types of weird stuff that you shouldn't be expecting to have an issue with that was patched up today. And last week they also patched up the stim glitch by adding a delay in the stimming time. So now that hiding in the gas problem is no longer there. But hopefully in the next coming week, we can see some new stuff coming in. I know on the 20th, there's supposed to be some nice events coming with the Haunting of Verdansk and stuff like that. So we'll definitely have a lot more to talk to you about. Armored Royale is still in. Very happy about that. Got a video dropping for that tomorrow. Thanks for checking out the video, guys. Stay tuned to make sure to like, follow, and subscribe for more content.